Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Know what's inside Lean Pockets turkey broccoli and cheese? White meat turkey, broccoli, real cheddar, and still only 7 grams of fat.
What are you gonna pick?
Lean Pockets.
Need a little excitement? Step into a slip jam. Oh, yeah.
Earlier on tonight on TBS, we heard Konnan make the call out to Kevin Nash or Lex Luger from the New World Order. Well, who came out but the Disco Inferno, and Konnan is not going to back away from a challenge of the Disco Inferno, and here comes the K-Dog.
Well, you can tell that Konnan is still upset at his ouster from the Wolfpac. He's had verbal confrontations as well as physical with both Lex Luger and Kevin Nash. Tonight, he called out any of the NWO members to face him here on Saturday night. And it's that New World Order wannabe, the Disco Inferno, that took up the challenge.
First time, we're going to rock it one more time. Yo, 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 let me speak on this. Orale! Arriba la raza!
This portion of WCW Saturday Night is brought to you by 1010321. Dial it and save 50% on calls over 10 minutes.
Slip into the goal of May. Lower the mirror ball. Disco lives on Saturday night.
And as Disco would be the first to tell you, he's a main eventer. Yeah. And he's in the main event slot here on WCW Saturday night on the Superstation TBS.
Well, Disco is very hard to take, even in small doses. I think I can hear a glad amen on that one, but he is a talented wrestler. You gotta give him that kind of credit.
Well, he's a talented wrestler when he has the backup of the NWO at ringside, when he has Scott Hall there to interfere in a match, like he did recently when he scored, Disco Inferno scored a tainted victory over Wrath. He considers himself a main eventer because he interfered at Starrcade during the Kevin Nash Goldberg match, and then once again interfered at the sold out pay-per-view during that ladder match, that physical, brutal ladder match between Goldberg and Scott Hall.
Disco Inferno has wormed his way into the good graces of the NWO Wolfpack. And the reason I know that, Mike, they're not out here beating him into a pulp for wearing their colors. You know, they might not accept him fully, but they're tolerating him.
I think tolerating is a good word, and maybe another word would be that they're amused by him.
True.
I have not heard any official confirmation from either Hollywood Hogan, Kevin Nash, or even Scott Hall that the Disco Inferno was a full-fledged, true NWO member. I think it's still in his mind.
Oh, yeah. That's about the only thing in there. Pretty lonely thought. Konnan, former member of the Wolfpack, taking on the president of the Wolfpack fan club, Disco Inferno. Disco backs him into the corner. Drives the shoulder into the midsection on Konnan. Shoots him across. Reversal by Konnan. Disco into the ropes. Back drop. Oh, ho! Disco hit hard on that hip. Snapmare takeover from Konnan. Here we go.
Oh,
ooh, the basement drop kick just connected.
That dropkick connects from in tight, and look at how quickly Konnan follows up his advantage. That's the key to success. Once you have the man down, take him out, put him away. And Konnan, very, very nicely done in the corner with the attack on Disco Inferno.
Well, everyone here on Saturday night in the arena are certainly bowdy, bowdy, and or rowdy, rowdy. They're behind the K-Dog, and Disco Inferno having some words with the fans here at ringside.
And I'm rowdy, rowdy about Super Brawl, upcoming in Oakland, California, on Sunday, February the 21st, when Ric Flair gets his shot at Hollywood Hogan. Yes, the world's heavyweight title is on the line, but Ric Flair just wants Hollywood Hogan in the ring, one-on-one. It's payback time at Super Brawl for the new boss of World Championship Wrestling, the Nature Boy, Ric Flair.
Can Ric Flair once again be World Heavyweight Champion? Can he now say the 14-time World Heavyweight Champion? We will find out on pay-per-view February 21st from Oakland, California at Super Brawl 9. Disco Inferno a mini wiggle from the second turnbuckle. Oh, drops the elbow across the shoulder of Konnan. Lateral press cover from Disco Inferno. Just that close.
Drastic change in the momentum, the pace of this matchup, which saw Konnan dominate off the opening bell. And now the Disco Inferno has turned the tide and attempting to neutralize Konnan now with the reverse chin lock.
It was Konnan that made the challenge near the top of our broadcast. He called out either Kevin Nash or Lex Luger. Nash, Luger didn't bother. They sent out the Disco Inferno, we can only assume, to do their bidding.
Oh, wait a minute. They sent out the Disco Inferno? Are you convinced of that?
I'm convinced.
Or did he just volunteer for the duty?
I don't think Disco Inferno is, oh, let's just say stupid enough to come out and wrestle Konnan on his own free will and volition. I think, and we didn't have a camera back there to find it, but my guess is Nash and Luger back there behind that big wall told Disco, hey, there's the challenge. We're not going to go out there. You go out there. Do our fighting for us. And Disco, blindly following along with Nash and Luger, came on out.
Oh, you think that he's here doing the NWO's dirty work?
Sure.
You see, I'm under the impression that he's out here trying to convince the NWO members that he should be a part of their group. And that's why he stepped up and accepted the challenge, because he thinks a victory over this former Wolfpac member, Konnan, would put him in that elite NWO faction.
Well, if Disco Inferno can get the victory over Konnan here on Saturday night, you can rest assured he will be given a complete red and black wardrobe that would bring tears to your eyes. Disco Inferno now taking over on Konnan. Snapmare takeover out of the corner.
You know, to this point, Disco's red and black wardrobe has been purchased at the souvenir stand at WCW events.
Exactly. They won't even take his credit card. Reverse chin lock on Konnan. Nice positioning from the Disco Inferno, just under the chin, not quite a chokehold. Konnan trying to fight out. And Disco Inferno, give him credit. He has taken the fight to Konnan here on TBS.
K-Dog tries to mount an offensive, knows that he needs to get to his feet. He does so, but he's stopped dead in his tracks as Disco connects with a back elbow.
And Disco Inferno wasting valuable, precious time as Konnan is out in the ring. Another wiggle from the middle turnbuckle. Disco sets him up. Konnan out of the way. Disco wasted too much time.
Drop down with that elbow drop off the middle rope. No Konnan there, but Konnan is back, rolling clothesline.
And Disco Inferno staggers back to his feet. Reversal. Konnan into the ropes. Misses a clothesline again. And a bulldog from the K-Dog.
Float over into the bulldog. Here comes the cover.
Lateral press. Can Konnan hang on? He got the two. Konnan shoots Disco across into the ropes. Oh, Disco cut him off. Disco may be setting him up for the chart buster. There's the neck breaker.
That's usually the move. Goes for the press instead.
An early pin attempt, and he got two.
Did he get him?
Oh,
I thought he had him that time.
Credit Mickey J, the referee, for that one. He saw Konnan sneak that shoulder up at 2 9/10. Shoots Konnan in. Oh, no. The DDT on the Disco Inferno. One arm pin from Konnan. No. Disco out at two.
And that was the key. He did not have proper weight distribution on the pinfall attempt. After he hit him with the DDT, he rolled over. He only had one arm on Disco and only able to get a two count.
Leapfrog from Konnan. Disco, cut him off. Chartbuster, no. Escape from Konnan. Leapfrog, oh. Back kick, heel kick, face jam on Disco.
Great strategy by Konnan to avoid the Chartbuster. He's going to try and hook on the Tequila Sunrise.
Here we go.
He's got the arm. He's got the leg. He's got him hooked.
That may do it. Can Disco hang on? Can the Disco Inferno survive? No. There it is. Disco gives it up, and Konnan with the Tequila Sunrise may actually shut up the Disco Inferno for a couple of days.
What a matchup on our Saturday night main event. Konnan able to fight off quite an offensive from the Disco Inferno, even to the point that it looked like Disco was going to hit the chart buster.
That's a message to Kevin Nash, Lex Luger, and Scott Hall, heard loud and clear.
Your time is coming.
Konnan with the victory, letting everyone in the Wolfpac know he did not appreciate the way he was treated. Konnan entrance to the NWO. For Iron Mike today, I'm Scott Hudson. We'll see you Monday night from Dallas on Nitro.